Hello guys, welcome to the new lecture of code practice, and in this lecture we will be printing even and odd numbers using producer and consumer. As you know guys, basically producer and consumer are used to have interaction between two threads, and it is used in multi-threading so that we can achieve the interaction between the threads. So in this, one thread will be producing the odd numbers and one thread will produce the even numbers. So let's see how it works. So to make this happen guys, we need one class, and let's say it is list number our classes. Now what we need a variable here and two methods. One will be printing even number and another will be printing odd numbers. Now it will be printing even and it will be printing odd numbers. So what we will do is this row, whenever this is called, just increment the number by 1, and when this is called, increment the number by 1 also. Now this is done, and what we need, a producer for printing numbers and a consumer for printing numbers. So we will make a producer class by implementing runnable interface, and we will override that run method of runnable interface, and we will say while it is true, print my odd numbers. Now so for that guys, if you see, we need this method or this method here. So we need a reference variable here so that we can call the method of this class, that is print all. So we will basically initializing this method here by defining this, and we will be making a constructor which will be list number, which will be initialized with list number, and we will say is this dot list number will be initialized with list number. Now we can call our method here, that is list number dot print odd. Now we will use this same for our consumer also. And we will define the constructor. Like this, and this will say print even. Now we need to call this, start this thread so that we can print the objects. So for that, what we will do is list number new Yes, we need this object, and this will be list number. Now we will pass this in our producer object. Here, okay, ओके सॉरी वी डिंट डिफाइन मेन मेथड हियर दैट्स व्हाई नाउ वी विल कॉपी दिस कोड एंड पेस्ट हियर एंड नाउ वी विल बी मेकिंग अवर थ्रेड टू स्टार्ट दिस एंड वी विल पास अवर अनेबल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑब्जेक्ट हेयर and we will say t1.start and same for consumer guys new consumer and initialize it to new local variable and another thread which will be taking this implementation object of thread class that is consumer and yes and we will start this thread now let's see guys what will happen if we run this program okay we didn't print anything that's why now let's print this also guys see this is our basically this is going to infinity now guys but we need a basically first producer should print and after that consumer should print so that we need wait and notify we want if let's say I'm declaring a variable here and that I can use then can I'm letting it as flag I'm letting a flag that is false if flag is set then go to wait okay and otherwise increment this number print this number and set this flag as true and notify the other thread so basically if it is not set I will print my number and I will notify another thread who is waiting for this thread's acknowledgement and same here guys also if it is not set then I will wait and I will wait and if it is not set I will print this and I will set my flag value to false and I will notify other thread who is waiting for this now let's see guys this is an error we need to catch this exception or throws it yes now let's see what will happen illegal monitor state exception so guys as you know when we are accessing a shared object between two threads then we need to have synchronization is there because every thread object maintains a lock or monitor over it so to release that lock we need synchronized keyword on that method so that that block piece of block or that method can work in a synchronized manner this is very important guys and now let me add sleep method over here so that you can see easily who is printing, and this is of thread class so that you guys can see who is printing what. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, and this is, guys, this is the thing we wanted. Now let me do one thing. Let me add a print statement. Like, producer is using printOut method, so I will say producer. And here I will say consumer. Now let's run these guys. Consumer, producer. As you can see, guys, these are printing in one by one order, and this is how a producer and consumer interacts. Two threads interact. So that's it for now. That's it for now, guys. Thank you, and if you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel, and please, if you have any thoughts, please comment down in the comment box, and if you want any kind of specific video, please let me know also. Thank you, guys. Thanks a lot.